eyes are blue. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful day.
Was a song you came along. I lay awake the whole night through. If I should dare to think you care, this is what I'd say to you.
Charmaine, may I now ask you to answer truthfully the following questions. Charmaine, did you come here at your own free will to bind yourself in the love and service of your husband?
Yes, Father.
Daryl, did you come here of your own free will with you to bind yourself in the love and service of your wife?
Yes, Father.
Daryl and Charmaine, are you both ready to raise as good Christians the children whom God will give you?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Daryl and Charmaine, since you wish to contract holy matrimony, please join your right hands, and express your intentions before God and His church. Charmaine, do you take Daryl here present for your lawful husband according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to him as his wife?
Yes, I do.
And do you accept him as your lawful husband?
Yes, I do.
Daryl, do you take Charmaine here present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to her as her husband?
Yes, I do.
And do you accept her as your lawful wife?
Yes, I do.
Daryl and Charmaine, to exchange their personal vows, now please say together with a prayer of commitment.
Charmaine, I affirm my love to you as I invite you to share my life. I promise always to respect you with kindness, unselfishness, and trust. I will work by your side to create a wonderful life together. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to love you in good times and in bad, to be your best friend, to laugh with you when life seems easy, and to comfort you when it seems hard. I promise to cherish you, a commitment made in love, and to always hold you in highest regard. These things I give to you today and all the days of our life.
Daryl, today I give myself to you in marriage. I promise to keep having fun with you, to be your best friend, to respect and support you, to be patient with you as you will with me, to work with you to achieve our dreams and aspiration, to accept you regardless, and to share life with you throughout the years. This is my commitment, made in love, kept in faith, and eternally made new.
Together, please repeat after me. Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and one soul. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. Until death do us part. And I, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those you present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
From this day on, now and forever.
Charmaine, I give you this ari as a pledge of my dedication and constant concern for your welfare and that of the children God will give us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Mariel, I accept this token from your hand with my total confidence in you for our life together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Why can't they understand the way we feel? They just don't trust what they can't explain. I know it different.
For Daryl and Charmaine, that God may keep their hearts united forever and with growing love for each other. In sickness and in health, may they find your strength. In doubts and trouble, may they see your light. In hurts and failures, may they find your pardon. In loneliness and desperation, may they find your joy. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
There's two things I know for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl. As I drop to my knees by her bed at night, she talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all of the joy in my life. Oh, but most of all, for butterfly kisses after bedtime prayer, sticking little white flowers looks funny, Daddy, but I sure tried. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something right to deserve a hug every morning and butterfly kisses at night. She's looking like her mama a little more every day. One part woman, the other part girl. To perfume and makeup from ribbons and curls. Trying her wings out in a great big world. But I remember butterfly kisses after bedtime prayer, sticking little white flowers all up in her hair. You know how much I love you, Daddy, but if you don't mind, I'm only gonna kiss you on the cheek this time. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something right. Deserve her love every morning and butterfly kisses at night.
All the precious time.
Oh, like the wind, the years go by.
Our family is very much happy because we found each other. We know very much that you are ready to face the married life. You are, shall I say, matured already. You have enough resources to bring up your family. I hope that you remain faithful to each other. And on your way, don't forget to put or place God at the center of your life. Always pray. Always thank God for all the blessings that you have. And then you also, don't forget to pray for us also. Don't forget to pray for your parents, for your relatives, because they are a part of you. So, again, congratulations and best wishes.
On occasions like this, I would like to share with you an anecdote which dates back to the Middle Ages. It is said that after 40 long days, the College of Cardinals failed to elect a new pope. But on the 61st day, the white smoke was emitted from the Vatican to signal the election of a new pope. The new pope immediately rushed to the hovel of his widowed mother at the outskirts of Rome and told his mother, "Mama, I'm giving you this papal ring because without you and my deceased father, there will be no pope today." The mother refused and said, "No, I will give you this wedding band which your father gave me during our wedding, because without this wedding band, there will be no pope today." That underscores the importance of marriage and the family. So today, as we celebrate the marriage between Darrell and Charmaine, we are reminded that both the state and the church sanctify the strength of the family. But let me remind both of you that too much may not be too good. That's why I am the author of the bill on responsible parenthood and population management. Thank you very much.
Darrell is my nephew by marriage, right? And I would just like to say that you make a beautiful couple, and I hope you have many beautiful children. I hope you have a long, happy life together. May you always be best of friends and keep on diving together. So, God bless. Thank you.
After such a beautiful wedding ceremony and the prayers, especially the gospel, there's nothing that I can say that is of real meaning. But I'd like to just call attention to the fact that Charmaine, your husband and your father-in-law and your grandmother-in-law are here, and I'd like to assure you that your grandfather, Mampitong, is very much with us here. He would not miss this beautiful occasion. It's a very happy occasion. So we on the Abueva side, come all the way from Duero Bohol to Subic. It's a long way, and a number of us even came from the United States. So this makes it a very special occasion. Last year, my wife and I celebrated our 50th wedding anniversary. It's a long time. And in all those years, we attend weddings, wedding after wedding, and we renew our wedding vows. So through the coming years, you will be doing that every year with many friends getting married. And it's always happy. But the main thought really is that you are together and that you have a loving partner up there. So may you, there is the prayer that we did. We also pray that you bless Darrell and Charmaine with a family so blissful, prosperous and ever healthy. And above all, filled with love, faith and hope that is founded in you. Up there, we pray.
I wasn't really prepared to make this speech, but I did promise the good couple that I would be here to send this short message. I am doubly honored to be a godfather and at the same time to say a few words. I think that it's very difficult to compose a nice message for both of them because they have very good head and shoulders. I've known Charmaine for some time now. We've been diving together, and Darrell as well. But to me, this occasion today resembles what I refer to as a piece of heaven. It is something to do with relationships, and it is a relationship with God, yourselves, your friends, and among others, the other friends that you might find along the way. And so, please do add to this piece of heaven of yours a little Darrell and a Charmaine right away. Thank you.
Agunyo kalilimutan, the family, the smallest part of the society, the family always had a big part in our community. At alam naman ninyo ang nangyayari sa family ngayon. And this is a challenge for you, no? Darrell and Charmaine. You have a beautiful vow. Nakangiti lang ako kanina because napakaganda, mabulaklak ng mga salita ang ginawa ninyo. Pero is it for 5 years? Is it for 10 years? Or for the rest of your life? Yan ang prayer natin. So, Charles, Charmaine, Darrell, we pray always for you. And please, likewise, as I've said, we pray for them also. It's a part of our community. It's a Christian way of giving our our service, our joy to them as we celebrate this holy matrimony day this afternoon. So please join us in praying and blessing our newly wedded couple. Let us all stand.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but everyone.
Fall in love again. Oh, I never fall in love again. Don't tell me what it's all about, 'cause I've been there and I'm glad I'm out. Out of those chains that bind you, that is why I'm here to remind you. What do you get when you give your heart? You get it all broken up and battered. That's what you get, a heart that's shattered. I never fall in love again. Oh, I never fall in love again.
And now the reason for our occasion tonight, we would like to call on the newlyweds,
Mr. Daryl and Charmaine Abueva.
Of Daryl and Charmaine, my family welcomes all of you, my friends and relatives from St. Paul the Apostle Parish, from Regina Rosary Dominican Sisters, from as far as my friends in Negros, and of course as far as the USA. Daryl and Charmaine made sure we are all here gathered. Their friends from, Charmaine's friends from grade school, in high school and college. I understand they're all here. Their common friends of the diving where they've developed their friendship and their love affair. I'm very honored to welcome you all. I don't know if I should have prepared a good speech, but I thought the most appropriate is to give a message from my heart. Thank you very much for coming. Let's all celebrate their wedding day.
Let us put ourselves in the holy presence of the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bless us, O Lord, and this your gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Mary's death and all the rest. Daryl has been my friend for almost 20 years. So it's kind of stay, so even now we stay together. I just want to say I'm very happy for you. And for your second question.
Just make sure that you keep your promises for Charmaine. The one you were telling her a while ago. It was kind of sweet. And that's it for both of you. I wish you all the happiness. So I'd like to propose a toast for both of you. To propose a toast for Darren and Charmaine. God bless and all the happiness for you.
Charmaine's friend for too long, when we were still this small. And you know how it is between close friends, when you can almost finish each other's sentences and you know, you can almost see thought balloons from your friend. So when Charmaine told me that she was finally getting engaged 4 months ago, I literally almost fell off my chair. For such a good friend, you know, it was the last thing I expected Charmaine to tell me. And I had two good reasons why. Now, the first reason was I thought it was so soon. It was so soon. Because just three months before she told me she was getting married. She was still with me, she visited me, and we spent one whole week together. And she was starting to go out again with this guy, Daryl. And you know, they were just starting to, I think, seriously see each other. And you know, she was missing him, but then she said, "Maita, I can't text him that I miss him, baka he'll think I'm so, you know, ano naman iisipin niya." And so she would ask me, "Maita, should I end this text with a smiley face? Baka Daryl might think naman too much of me." So, but she said, "But I really miss him." So I go, "You know what, this is what you say." So we would actually strategize on what to say. So Daryl, whatever text you got, that was from me. So that was one. I felt it was really too soon. And the second reason was I knew Charmaine enjoyed being single. Charmaine is in her fabulous mid-30s. And we actually belong to a group of wonderful women over there, which we call the Bold and the Beautiful. And a lot of them, you know, it's a big group of women and a lot of them are married, but then there's a shrinking group of single women in their mid-30s. But then what's great is that, you know, I think that's why Charmaine and I got really close also together with Sandy, was that, you know, we were part of that shrinking group. But we were also part of that group who loved being single, right? Who enjoyed single life. And that's why when Charmaine was telling me she had plans, you know, what if I work abroad, etc. And we were all, of course, very supportive. So again, when she told me she was getting married, I'm like, wow, what happens to all your plans, right? But then again, you know, up until she was walking down the aisle, I couldn't believe it. Actually, maybe that's why I was crying a lot. It was like a dream, but I think the answer was simple. There was no complicated answer to why she was getting married. I mean, the answer was so simple. The answer was just one word, I thought. And the word was Daryl. Daryl. Kiss the... You know, with Daryl, I think it didn't make sense to wait any longer. And I think whatever personal plans Charmaine had, you know, were meaningless without Daryl beside her. And so I wish you both, I love you both. Charmaine, I love you so much. You're like a sister. And, you know, I remember Charmaine would always tell me, I asked her, what did you see in Daryl? Of course, Daryl, I knew you had all the best qualities, but I just had to ask Charmaine for confirmation. And she said, you know, Maita, because it was so easy. The relationship was so easy. And for friends that have seen Charmaine go through the good relationship and the not so good one, we understood what she meant. And Daryl, all I can say, good luck. You're officially part of the BNB, and I love you both. Have a happy life.
Of course, you know, I wish you the best, Charmaine and Daryl. And I have to say that during the last couple of months, Charmaine has been, you know, really enjoying herself, her single life, traveling. And that's why I think it's divine providence that you found each other, because in one of our private moments with Charmaine in our conversations, she would always say that Daryl seemed to be it. He was the fit. Everything was smooth sailing between the two of them, and that's why she knew that this must be it. And as Maita may have already introduced the B&Bs to you, normally these very strong-willed women, to protect their friends, Daryl sort of went through a panel. And I have to say that he passed our standards with flying colors. So welcome to the group, and I wish you the best, both of you. Thank you.
Daryl is my dive master. So every time, every moment, every second, every minute I'm down there, he makes sure I'm alive. So that's how, you know, how important his relationship. But I and my fellow divers over there, all you know, 12 of them, are very happy because we were present at the creation. Okay? Almost 1 year ago, a little more than 1 year ago, we were together in Tubataha. Charmaine was with another group, Bell's group, and we were with the Morato group. Hindi sila nagpapansinan. Wala. Dead ma, you know? Daryl would always take a sideways glance and then keep quiet. So clearly he was somebody, a man who was looking for his meaning in life. I am the reason why they had their first solo date. About 2 weeks, di ba? Tama ba? Oh, it was pre-arranged but not quite. Because the group decided to have a reunion after the two Bataha dive. And everybody was supposed to come. But at the last minute, everybody dropped off except me. Okay, daw, tumatawa si Charmaine. But then Daryl very slyly said, Alan, bukang hindi tuloy eh. Only to find out the day after, sabi niya, pare, natuloy in the last minute, si Charmaine lang ang dumating. Yun ang umpisa. Yun ang umpisa, we were present at the creation. But anyway, as a diver, with my dive master, my only wish is that now that he has found a permanent buddy, okay, Daryl and Charmaine, we, your divers group, wish you all the best. to be a little poetic about it, let's say, if you must swim with the tide, swim together. If you must swim against the current, by all means, swim together against the current. But always be together. So that when you surface, you'll find happiness, you'll find love, you'll find fresh air, and you'll find all of us waiting and hoping that all both of you will be happy forever. So, ganun lang. Thank you very much.
And it's Charmaine and Sharon's eyes. When we were kids, I remember that my sister and I had very different personalities. She was very cool and feminine, and I was the opposite. Despite this, however, since it's her wedding day today, I will admit that she was very much my idol back then. In grade school, she got into singing for the Greek club. Why are you crying? And played volleyball for the varsity team during her senior grade school years. It was very tough to get into both clubs, but she made it without sweat. At one try, she passed the Glee Club auditions. As for volleyball, she was always part of the first six players and was an excellent spiker for the team. As I watched Ate, I was so proud of her. I knew I wanted to be like my big sister. When I reached grade 3, the initial prerequisite in joining the Glee Club, I eagerly auditioned. I tried again in grade 4, grade 5, and up to grade 6, I think, but never made it. I remember my sister saying that the grade school Glee Club isn't as great anyway, so it didn't really matter. Instead, she encouraged me to join the high school Glee Club, which had a better moderator and had a lot of exposure activities. Fortunately, by then, I improved and I made it. With volleyball, she was as supportive to me. I wasn't as good as her, but she would always encourage me to join the summer leagues with her and would coach me either with techniques or just simply being a sport if I don't get to actually play it during the games. Up to now, she continues to do that, always wanting me to get into the good things that she has experienced for herself. I think she does that to the rest of her loved ones. That's Ate's nature. What Ate plans for, she gets. I don't know how she does it, but I guess it's her talent, good attitude, a bit of hard work, and lots of luck that makes her achieve all her dreams. So far, everything that I remembered her saying about her future came true, or is little by little coming true. Her desire for independence right after college, her dreams of traveling the country and the world, her balanced lifestyle, and even getting married in 2006 were all plans that came true. Since 4 or 5 years ago, when friends and relatives would teasingly ask her when she's ever getting married, she would always say, in year 2006. And when asked to whom, she'd say, hindi ko pa kilala. Ayun, nakilala niya si Manong ng 2005. At 2006 ngayon, she got married. Ate is cool, but is always determined to accomplish things. She's serious about life, but fun-loving too. She's well-respected, but can be very amusing. She's into the field of logistics, pero laging naliligaw sa daan. Anyway, Ate, thank you for everything. Thank you for being my big sister. Thank you for being my friend. Congratulations. And best wishes to you and Manong. Manong, good luck at sobrang OC yan. Ingat ka na lang.
Wide enough, baby.
If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry.
Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby. Remember the day I set you free.
Awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. But you're lovely, with your smile so warm and your cheek so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you.
This is the first time I'm surprised being called here. And I'm surprised really na they called me for another number. I'd like to give a message to Daryl. When we have our wedding in Victoria's before, I can't remember yung mga tiling-tiling sa baso. I can't remember those things. It seems things just passed so quickly. I cannot remember what I've done and how I feel. But now I would like to share this with Charmaine and Daryl. I'd like to share with you the blessings that the Lord has given me. When I look back, I always say this as a philosophy in my life. Now, 37 years after our wedding, I say, thank God, you give us a wonderful life, a wonderful family, a blissful 37 years of married life. That's the kind of message I'd like to share with Charmaine and Daryl. To look back to this day, 40 years later, and say, thank God, thank for all the blessings that you've given us. Thanks for all the friends and relatives who have been supporting us. Sa amin, walang nagsasabi sa akin noon because suicide yung ginawa ko. I wasn't as old as you were. Pero looking back, I believe I still go on the same way as I would like to do it again. Even if I say it was a suicide, I'll still marry my wife. Dahil
for all the wonderful things that the Lord has given us. The Lord has given us beautiful children. The Lord has given us wonderful friends, wonderful relatives. I've said this, this is a very old song. No. I did not adapt this, but just one paragraph. Now, it fits into what my message is this evening. Nung una, hindi ko iniisip yun, but I say this very clearly. I love you more today than yesterday, but not as much as tomorrow. I love you more today than yesterday, my darling, not as much as tomorrow. Ganon ang mensahe ko sa inyo. Magmamahalan kayo mahigit ngayon kaysa bukas. God bless.
To our dear friends, relatives, and guests, our family is delighted to thank you all for honoring our invitation to join us in this nuptial celebration, which unites our loved ones. We are aware that you may have been inconvenienced by coming here, coming from, for gracing this occasion, coming from different places. Sa mga Abueva, may nanggaling ng Misamis, Bohol, Negros, Cebu, even the United States. And on the part of our family, coming from Central Luzon to as far as Southern, Ilocos Sur. Okay. And we know that you took time to join us here in this very important event in the lives of Charmaine and Daryl. We thank you all for coming here. We thank you for all the inspiring messages and the words of wisdom that you gave to Charmaine and Daryl. For us, I think my wife have something to say for Daryl and Charmaine. But then, yeah, look at her. Pinandidilatan ako ng mata nung dinigit ko yung... So, I might as well do this speaking. Daryl and Charmaine, we have talked a lot about your future life, the advices, and I need not repeat them again or say them again. Alam nyo na kung ano yun, okay? There's one thing though that we were not able to tell you. And this is what worries me also, because Charmaine is the first in our family to get married, and Daryl too is the first in their family to get married. Wala pang apo yung aming balae, ganun din kami. So my worry is that pag nagkaanak sila, kanino una yung baby? Para pag-usapan natin. Okay? During weekends, 2 days sa kanila. Yung working days na 5 days, yung tatlo sa amin, dalawa sa inyo na. Or vice versa. I would like to reiterate our heartfelt thanks for all of you for gracing this occasion and for all your best wishes for Daryl and Charmaine. Daryl, may binubulong. Even in my driving, siya yung bumubulong din. So, welcome daw, Daryl, in our family.
Good evening. I'm not surprised. Actually, I prepared a speech already.
So I won't forget what I have to say to this celebration. So we cannot express how we can thank God for giving us all the blessings, especially on this special moment in our lives. Without Him, this would not happen. We also would like to thank our parents for what we are today. Thank you to our brothers and sisters, Myra, Sharon, Dondi, Bob, Alan, and Rocky, for being supportive to us. We also would like to thank our ninongs and ninangs for the guidance that they will impart to us, especially we heard something from them during the wedding ceremony. We will be looking forward to more of that. And I would also like to thank my best man for offering a toast. Medyo mahiyain siya. I was, hindi ko masyado marinig kanina, pero alam ko na yung sinasabi niya. I would also like to thank Maita and Sandy. Hindi ko alam, iniimbestigahan niyo na pala ako. Nung nag-meeting kayo, buti na lang pumasa, no? At I also never expected that my wife, Charmaine, misses me when she's out of the country. Well, thank you to our guests and friends for coming all over to Subic. Thank you very much. I would also like to thank Mr. Alan Ortiz. Sir! Binuking mo ako, pero totoo yun. We planned a get-together after the trip. Rocio and I were planning about it. But I was the one insisting to have that get-together. But I already have a plan. The last minute, everybody will back out. So I made it a point that everyone back out. So I get to talk to Charmaine alone. You know. Well, thank you for that message, Mr. Ortiz. And lastly, I would like to thank one person in this occasion. I'm so grateful for having her here on this occasion, on my wedding. I would like to thank my wife. Kasi if she's not here, naging runaway bride. Wala ang celebration itong gabing ito. I want to thank her because I found my purpose in life. And that is loving her and taking care of her. I love you very much, honey. So, it's just a start of the party. The dance is about to start, so we expect you to enjoy the night. Thank you very much.
Hi, Daryl, Charmaine, you know, I love you very much. Just so happy that you're getting married. When I found out, you know, I cried and everything. I'm just so happy for you, bro. You'll always be my bro, underwater and on the surface. Congratulations. I love you both.
Congratulations, Daryl and Charmaine.
Congratulations, guys.
Congrats.
Congratulations. Have a happy life together.
Congratulations, Daryl and Charmaine. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors together as husband and wife.
Love you guys. You're awesome and all the best.
and I hope to die with you soon.
Congratulations, guys. We love you.
Thanks for the food, Daryl and Charmaine.
Same here.
Congratulations, guys. It's been great.
Congrats, Charmaine. I love the gown.
Best wishes and congratulations. Frumpy the dog.
Best wishes to the both of you. I know you're going to make a good family. And take good care of each other. That's all. Best wishes.
To my brother, Daryl, I'm happy for you. You got married at the right time. You got the perfect girl for you. That's all. Thank you. I'm happy for the both of you.
Two words.
Many kids. Many kids. Congratulations and best wishes.
I don't have any more messages. But congratulations. Good luck. Hindi pala good luck. Congratulations. Tapos Manong, welcome to the family. Thank you, thank you. Congrats and best wishes. Meron lang akong i-share na secret. Yung date na nag-propose si Daryl was January 4, 2006. It's my wedding day. So, si Charmaine is one of my bridesmaids. And after the wedding, the ceremony, on the way to the church, to the hotel, nag-propose si Daryl. Okay? So, that's the secret. Housemate, huwag ka magagalit. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Is a bloom shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel like it's a beautiful day. To let it get away, on the road, but you got destination in the mind, in the maze of her imagination, your love is down. Even if that doesn't ring true, you've been all over, and it's been all over you. It's a beautiful day. Clearing the sea out, see the bedwind fires at night, see the oil fields at first light, and see the birds of the leaving your mouth. After the flood, all the colors came out. It was a beautiful.